Hello everyone. Today in this class, I'm going to teach you the first unit in which we are also having many details like features of Python, data types. These two topics I'm going to teach you today, but it is also having many other topics. And I will also discuss list, dictionaries and tuples. Now let us get into the syllabus. What is the history of Python programming? Python was developed by Sudhakaran Bose in the late 80s and early 90s at the National Research Institute for Mathematics and Computer Science in Netherlands. Actually, there was a language called ABC, which is called as the successor of Python programming. And Wido von Rosen worked for ABC language, and while in his career, while he was working for ABC language, he has seen many issues with that particular language, but he liked that language. So what he did later, he wants to do some good project. That time he wants, he has grabbed all the syntax and good features of ABC language and fixed all the issues completely to create a very good scripting language. And the inspiration for name came from BBC TV show called Monty Python's Flying Circus, which was telecasted in BBC from 1969 to 74. And Wido von Rosen is a very big fan of this TV show and also wanted a very short, unique and slightly mysterious name for his invention. So the name Python has occurred. For quite some time he used to work for Google, and then he shifted to Dropbox. Later he has joined recently in the November 2020, he joined after retirement from Dropbox. He felt bored and he joined in the developing department of Microsoft to enhance the power of Python programming. So this Python programming language was released in 1991, and the latest version is Python 3.7.3. Python 2.7 and Python 3.7 are having a tight competition between those two. Both are having very good features and each is having their own fans. So coming to the applications of Python, it can be used with desktop applications, web applications, database applications, network programming, games, data analysis applications, machine learning, developing artificial intelligence applications and IoT. And because he worked for Google and Dropbox and also for YouTube, so internally Google and YouTube uses Python coding, including the Dropbox also uses Python coding. Now let us see the features of Python programming. The first one, it is easy to code. Because it is a high level programming language and it is very easy to learn compared to C, C++, C sharp, Java, etc. And it is also a very developer friendly language. Second one, it is free and open source. Python language is freely available at the official website www.python.org, and you can download it from this link. And it is open source, that means its source code is also available to the public and we can download it and also we can share it. Third one, it is object-oriented language. One of the key features of Python is object-oriented programming language, where you can create your own data type, you can keep the variables private and public and protected. And that means you can do the encapsulation, which means only necessary data and functions can be visible to other functions and many things can be hidden.
So next one, GUI programming support. GUI means graphical user interface, and it can be made using a module like PyQt5, PyQt4, WXPython or TK in Python. The most popular option is PyQt5 for creating this GUI with Python. And Python is a high-level language. When we write the programs in Python, we do not need to remember the system architecture, neither we need to manage the memory. Extensible features. Python is an extensible language. We can write some Python code into C or C++ languages, and also we can compile that code in C or C++ language. Python is portable language. Portability means once you have written this Python code for Windows platform, and it can run under Linux, Unix, Macintosh and etc. and you don't need to change your code. Next one, Python is integrated language. Python is also an integrated language because we can easily integrate Python with other languages like C and C++. So Python is an interpreted language. We know what is interpreter. Interpreter means which will read a line by line and debug it. So here Python is also executed line by line at a time. So there is no need to compile the Python code. This makes it easy to debug our code. So the source code of the Python is converted into an immediate form called bytecode. And Python has a very large standard libraries which will provide you almost every function that you need, so you don't need to write your own code for every single thing. And there are many libraries present in the Python for such as regular expressions, unit testing, web browsers, etc. So it is also called dynamically typed language. That means the type, which is integer, double and long, for a variable is actually given in C language. We will declare the variable before its initialization or use, but in Python you can directly use the variable, no need of declaration. So at the runtime it will be identified which type of data was stored in that. So Python data types. Data type is nothing but the classification of the data items. So it specifies the type of the value stored in a particular memory location. So Python supports the following built-in data types. One is scalar type, second one sequence type, third one mapping type, fourth one set type, fifth one mutable and immutable types. So first one, scalar data type. So int, float, complex, bool and none. These are considered as scalar data type. Int, float, complex, boolean and none. These are considered as scalar data types. So int means anything which is a whole number. It can be a zero or positive or a negative number, and there is no specific precision limit. So if you are writing negative number or a positive number with any precision, it is considered as an integer. There is a method. Usually integers can be binary, octal and hexadecimal values. So binary means if you are using 0 or 0B, then it is considered as binary, and this code is nothing but 216. And you people already learned how to convert this into binary into decimal in your first semester, so I am not discussing that here at present. If anybody needs any doubts, you can contact me later. I can explain you how to do this one. So next one, octal means you have to use 0 O before the number. So this is nothing but a 10 in decimal number system. So next one is hexadecimal. Whenever you want to say hexadecimal, you will be using 0x. This x and then the number. So this will be actually 15 in our decimal number system. And there is a method called type in Python, and using this method you can get what kind of a class it is. So for example, x is containing the number 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0, and you are using type of x. This is the variable name. So when you set this one, automatically it will show the class is integer class. That means x is containing an integer data. So int function, if you are using, it will convert a string or a float into an integer. For example, if you are using int of 100, this is actually string because it is enclosed in single quotations. It will be converted into a number 100, which is an integer number. So second point is float. Float data type means float point numbers are positive and negative. There is no zero for this. Okay, real numbers with a fractional part denoted by the decimal symbol or scientific notation. So if you see this here, 1 2 3 4 5 6, it is a float value. 3.142, it is a float value. -1.55 is a float value. 0.23, so there is a decimal point, and after a fractional part we are having decimal point and the values. So floats can be separated by underscore. So if you see this, 1 2 3 4 0.4 2.222 013 is a valid float. So floats can be separated by the underscores. The float function, if you are using, it will convert a string into float, integer also into a float. So for example, float 5.5, which is a string because it is enclosed in single quotations, it will be converted into 5.5 float value. Next, complex. If a complex number is a number with real and imaginary components like this. Next one, none. None means if you are using in C, we said void. Void means nothing. Similarly here, none in Python, which will represent a null object. And the next one is bool. Whenever you are saying bool, means it is a boolean value. Boolean value means either true or false. But here there are two bulletin values, capital T R U E, capital F A L S E, true or false. These are the built-in values. You cannot keep T as a small letter and F as a small letter. That time it will not be a valid boolean value. So here, if B is equals to capital T R U E, that means true. And type of B, if you are asking, it will say it is a boolean data type. Second data type is sequence data type. So a sequence is nothing but an ordered collection of similar or different data types. So Python has the following built-in sequence data types: string, list, and tuple. These three comes under sequence data type. String, list, and tuple comes under sequence data type. So string is nothing but a collection of one or more characters. They can be enclosed in single or double or triple quotations. A list is an object and it is an ordered collection of one or more values. But these values need not be same type. They can be of different types and they must be kept in square brackets. Tuple means it is an ordered collection of one or more data items, similar like list, but these data items put in the parenthesis. If you are using tuple, you have to keep it in parenthesis. If you are using list, you have to keep them in square. So dictionary, which is a mapping data type. Dictionary or DICT, it is an object and an unordered collection of data in a key value pair form. So a collection of such pairs is enclosed in flower brackets. See, 1 Raju, 2 Bill, 3 Ram, 4 Farah. These are the names, and a key is 1, Raju is the value. Key is 2, Bill is the value. Like this, key value pairs which are enclosed in flower brackets is considered as a dictionary. Now let us understand what is mutable and immutable types. So mutable means numbers, strings and tuples are immutable, which means their contents cannot be altered once after creation. If you cannot able to change them, it is considered as immutable. If you can able to change them, it is considered as mutables. So numbers, strings and tuples are immutables. That means you cannot alter them. But list and dictionaries are mutables. That means you can make changes, like you can add, delete, insert and rearrange the items in a list or dictionary. Next one is set data types. So set is mutable. Mutable means, already you have learned what is mutable. So mutable means you can add, delete, insert and rearrange the items. Then it is called as mutable. So set is a mutable, unordered collection of distinct hash table objects. A set object has suitable methods to perform mathematical set operations like union, intersection, difference, etc. So frozen set means it is immutable version. Immutable version means you cannot change once it is declared. That is why it is called frozen, freeze. Okay, so it is a set of whose elements are added from other iterables. Frozen set is immutable version of the set whose elements are added from other iterables. This is all for today's class, students. So in my next class, I'll come with operators explanation. Have a nice time. Be safe. Stay at home. Thank you.